Hello. In this video, I will bring up my little Arduino ESP32 robot. This robot uses a LiDAR sensor to sense obstacles, create a map of your room, to self-drive itself automatically using that map and interact with objects. I assembled this robot, set up its Arduino firmware and robotic software in previous videos. Let's begin by opening the robot sketch in Arduino IDE version 2. Do not update libraries or boards because newer versions can break the compilation. Connect ESP32 to the PC using a USB cable and make sure the board power switch is turned off. Select a generic ESP32 or ESP32S3 board to match your hardware and click the upload button. Press and hold the boot button for 3 to 5 seconds to proceed with the firmware upload. Open the Arduino serial monitor window and press the reset button. Your ESP32 should boot with a message asking to upload the sketch data. Close the serial monitor window and open the sketch data folder. Step into the data folder where the sketch data is stored. Delete all config YAML files except the one that matches your hardware. Rename it to config.yaml. This file describes your hardware configuration, including ESP32 pin assignments. Click in the code window. Press Ctrl+Shift+P, type upload, and click upload spiffs. Restart the Arduino IDE if the upload fails and retry the upload. Press and hold the boot button for 3 to 5 seconds to proceed with the sketch data upload. Close the spiffs upload window and reopen the Arduino serial monitor. Press the ESP32 reset button. Your ESP32 should reboot. Load the config.yaml file and enter the Wi-Fi configuration mode. If you prefer using the legacy Arduino IDE rather than the latest one, follow these steps. Open the robot sketch in Arduino IDE version 1.8.19. Select a generic ESP32 or ESP32S3 board to match your hardware. Connect ESP32 to the PC using a USB cable and make sure the board power switch is turned off. Select your COM port and click Upload. Press and hold the boot button for 3 to 5 seconds to proceed with the firmware upload. Open the Arduino serial monitor window and press the reset button. Your ESP32 should boot with a message asking to upload the sketch data. Close the serial monitor window. Launch the sketch data upload tool from the tools menu. Press and hold the boot button for 3 to 5 seconds to proceed with the sketch data upload. Reopen the Arduino serial monitor. Press the ESP32 reset button. Your ESP32 should reboot. Load the config.yaml file and enter the Wi-Fi configuration mode. The activity LED should appear solid on. Launch a command shell on your PC. Run ipconfig. Find your Wi-Fi adapter and note its IPv4 address. Connect your PC to the robot's Wi-Fi. Open a browser and navigate to the Wi-Fi configuration page. Enter your local Wi-Fi credentials. Also, enter the IPv4 address of your PC Wi-Fi adapter and click Connect. Your robot will store the Wi-Fi configuration and try connecting to your local Wi-Fi. Make sure your PC has reconnected back to your local Wi-Fi. Now we are ready to launch robot software on your PC. Make sure Docker is running in the background. Make sure the X server is running in the background as well. Set the X server display number to 0. Launch a Windows command shell. I prefer using Windows PowerShell. Launch the Docker image of the robot software. Open Arduino serial monitor. Place your robot on a pedestal to let the wheels rotate freely. Turn the robot's power switch on and press the ESP32 reset button. Your robot should connect to your local Wi-Fi. Try pressing the reset button again if the Wi-Fi connection fails. Run the physical robot launch command inside the Docker Linux shell. Your robot connects to your PC robot software, and the serial monitor displays periodic robot status updates. Your ESP32 activity LED should be blinking rapidly. Click the PowerShell plus icon while holding the Alt key to open a second PowerShell window. Launch another Docker Linux shell in that window. Run the robot teleoperation app. Press the W key to start moving forward. Press the W key again to increase the speed. Keep pressing that key until you reach the maximum speed. Press the X key multiple times to decelerate and go into reverse. Press the space key to stop and press the D key to spin right. Press the space key again to stop and press the A key to spin left. Press the space key again to stop the wheels. The motors seem to be working fine. Let's check the LiDAR sensor operation. Turn the power switch off and unplug the USB cable. Reattach the LiDAR to the robot. Open yet another PowerShell command window. Launch one more Docker Linux shell. Run LiDAR visualization software. Turn the robot power on. Your robot should reconnect to your PC and start streaming the distance data. All looks good. Let's power the robot off and shut down the PC software. In the next video, I will show you how to operate the robot, how to create a map of your place, and how to make your robot self-drive and avoid obstacles. If you need to reset your robot's Wi-Fi settings, here is what you need to do. Press the ESP32 reset button and immediately press and hold the boot button until the activity LED stops blinking rapidly. Release the boot button and your ESP32 will reboot into the Wi-Fi configuration mode.